So right underneath my car is this large Eremorhax camel spider just chilling here. And I'm sure as soon as I bother it, it'll go crazy. But let me see if I can capture it. Maybe a bit tough. It's on the run. Got the camel spider to calm down really quickly. And this is actually a male specimen. The way I can tell is the abdomen size is proportionally smaller in relation to the head. And this one is likely an adult. I think there are very few camel spiders in California that get much larger than this. First scorpion of the night, and very predictably, it is a dune scorpion, Smoringerous Mesensis. And yeah, these are quite aggressive, as you can tell. But I'm still confident I can tail this one. Possibly the most common scorpion in this area specifically, in lower dune areas. But anyway, gonna release this guy. I have to get it to let go first, otherwise it'll hold on and sting me. I've had this happen before. I got it to let go. Over here is another scorpion, and of course, it's a dune scorpion. Very small one, very standard. And not too far away, there's another scorpion. Back in here, it's another dune scorpion. Nothing too special. Come on, move. There it is. Here's the next scorpion. And this is not a dune scorpion. Instead, this is a yellow ground scorpion. This should be Paruroctonus confusus. Possibly baergi. I'm not sure if we're on the intergrade zone or not. Oh, very quick. Got it. And this is an adult, if not a subadult. Little blue death feigning beetle just hanging out in here. Probably came out of this hole when night fell. Even the little Idrodes ventricus or ventricosus beetles are out right now. These guys are funny. Doesn't seem very active though. Another little scorpion. And of course, it's another dune scorpion. A little small one. Another dune scorpion here. A medium-sized one. And there's also a smaller one right over here. Here's our next scorpion. And this one seems to be a Perioctinus. Now, as far as the species go, I don't really know. There's a few things it could be, namely Luteolus or Baergoensis. Not entirely sure. These guys are kind of a mess, but yes, this is a Perioctinus. I'm not sure what that fly is doing. Just caught this large Eremorhax. Probably the largest species that lives out here. Very nice specimen. Couldn't videotape myself catching it though, because losing a specimen like this would be very unfortunate, and there were a couple holes next to it. But yeah, quite an iconic species too, the one with the black tips on its pedipalps, but embarrassingly enough, I don't actually know what the species is, just the genus Eremorhax. Yeah, and these are quite aggressive, as you can tell, but non-venomous. Another dune scorpion back here. No adults yet. This is just another medium-sized one, as you can see. This is the largest dune scorpion thus far. Pretty large, but still not an adult. This one looks like it's ready to molt, it looks like. And yeah, tail this one. Another scorpion here. And this is another Parabehovis. I'm gonna lean towards Confucius on the ones I'm seeing out here. Not very large. Another scorpion here. Seems to be having a little meal. Not entirely sure what. And this is a Perioctinus. Still not sure which one it is. But yeah, seems to be eating a little beetle. Over here is a prowling spider, Suspira, or Suspira. Not sure how to pronounce that. And this one looks like none I've ever seen before. Over here. Pretty cool. And right next to this Suspira, there's another one over here. Different species though. This is the one I'm used to. Another dune scorpion here. Still not an adult. Next scorpion over here, and it seems to be another fully grown Paruroctonus. Of course, I'm still not sure which species this is. Over here is another yellow ground scorpion, already on the move. A subadult. This little dune scorpion managed to get a silverfish for dinner. Must have recently caught it because it hasn't started eating. Here's another dune scorpion. This is the largest one I've seen all night, so far at least. This is a better example of an adult. Pretty large, only get slightly larger than this. Another dune scorpion up in here. Medium-sized individual. First desert hairy scorpion of the night, chilling in here. Obviously not a very large one. Finally it calmed down. See if I can tail it. Very easy to tell that these are hairy scorpions because they have those interocular bands of darker pigmentation. Anyway, let that guy go. Another scorpion here. And this is another Paruroctonus, a very shiny species. And it's another adult. Been very lucky tonight with this species so far. Here's another one of these Paruroctonus, also an adult, yet again lucky. And I believe this to be the first male specimen that I've seen this night. So, let's see. Oh, this one's actually quite quick. And the first aggressive one I've seen tonight. Come back. Yeah, the other ones were quite nice. Not sure what this guy's deal is. Let go. No? Another Paruroctonus hanging out here. These seem to be in more prevalent numbers, higher up the dunes than lower down where the dune scorpions are more prevalent. Another Paruroctonus here. Also quite a large one. And flighty. Largest scorpion of the night so far. This pallid hairy scorpion. Quite a large one, and in fact, it may be gravid, which means little babies will pop out sooner or later. But anyway, see if I can get this one on my hand. See just how large it is. And it may also just be ready for another molt, because this one's not fully grown. Pallid hairy scorpions are the largest scorpion in the United States. So this one may have a little growing left to do. Little tenebrina beetle. Stenomorpha or something like that. I forget the name entirely. Definitely don't know the species. But yeah, pretty cool. And these guys are much smaller than the other sort of larger tenebrinids out here that are more common, like Asbolus and Aeliotes. Also play dead. This is sort of the last species of tenebrinid beetle that I know to live out here, but there may be more, I'm not sure. I think this is genus Eusatis. Definitely don't know the species. Here is a Perioctinus eating possibly a Smoringerous, or maybe another Perioctinus. Kind of tough to tell. I think it's another Perioctinus. So, cannibalism. Cannibalism is more frequent when it's between a larger and smaller individual. Right here is two more Eremorhabetes, and these are actually mating. So the male is on the bottom, inserting his spermatophore, and the female is on the top. Both of them are obviously sexually mature since they are mating, but interestingly enough, there's also a little ant getting in on the action, sort of just biting the female. But yeah, these two are indeed mating.